And welcome back to Hannity and Combs. Although Hillary Clinton scored the big win tonight in West Virginia, the superdelegate count is still leaning in favor of Senator Barack Obama. Now with Oregon and Kentucky primaries now in the sights, Hillary Clinton is looking to regain some support. So what is the Clinton camp's plan to win back some of these votes? Joining us now, Clinton supporter Lanny Davis. Lanny, I got to tell you something. Barack Obama, if he makes it, is going to barely crawl across the finish line. I think these exit polls for him tonight are absolutely devastating. 63% do not believe he's honest and trustworthy. 51% of voters say they believe he shares a lot of the views of his pastor, Reverend right here. If he has a matchup against Senator McCain, he only beats Senator McCain among Democratic primary voters, 51% to 28%. I would assume that your camp, the Clinton camp, is going to be using this data to make an appeal to superdelegates.
Well, we're going to use the positive data and let everybody just add up what Senator Obama's problem to date has been in every major swing industrial state. Now we're into rural states of West Virginia and Kentucky, which Bill Clinton carried.
Yeah,
Sean, but Hillary Clinton has talked economic issues, and that's why she's winning these voters that used to be called Reagan Democrats.
All right, but
that 28% defection that you just mentioned between the Obama, who would vote for Obama, is exactly the percentage of Democrats we lost when Ronald Reagan and then George Bush won in the 80s ran against white liberal candidates who weren't able to talk to blue-collar voters. So
yeah.
This is not about race. This is not about race. This is about not being able to connect with people who work for a living, and that is Senator Clinton's great strength, and it looks to be Senator Obama's weakness.
Hey, Lanny, it's Alan. Welcome back to our show. Does it trouble you that conservatives like my friend Sean here
conservatives, nice people. Go ahead.
Thanks for filling in the script there. They're using Hillary's victory here to sully up Obama, to weaken him should he be the nominee, which seems likely in a general election against John McCain.
Well, I don't know what sully up and weaken are characterizing words. I just talk facts, but somehow talking a fact then gets characterized. So Senator Clinton pointed out that the Associated Press reported that in Indiana and North Carolina, Senator Obama showed great weakness among white working class voters, the same way that Michael Dukakis, who was white, and Walter Mondale, who was white, did when Reagan Democrats defected and produced substantial Republican majorities. Now, that is a fact.
Right, at this point, though, Lanny, look,
it's not a criticism. It's a fact, and Senator Obama, if he's the nominee, has to deal with the facts about the way he's coming across to working people
and not
characterize people.
Lanny, as you know, I'm a Hillary supporter, but I also want a Democrat to win in the fall. And at this point, with such a steep hill for her to climb to get the nomination, anything at this point that's going to hurt Obama, does that not hurt the Democrats' chances and help John McCain in the fall?
Alan, I would agree with you that we shouldn't be attacking each other to help John McCain in the general election. How does it help John McCain and hurt Barack Obama to describe what is a fact that Obama has to deal with in order to win the election? It's like saying when we raise the Reverend Wright issue, well, that's something you shouldn't do because it hurts Senator Obama. In fact, it forced Senator Obama to address that issue rather than ignore it. Right now in the state of West Virginia, he's got a problem.
Right,
he has the same problem in Pennsylvania and Ohio.
We got 30 seconds here, Lanny.
He's got to deal with that problem now.
Yes or no, can she win?
I think she can win if superdelegates ask themselves the question, who is the strongest candidate against John McCain?
We got to figure out if the math supports what you just said. Thank you so much for being with us. Coming